I'm here to read a book about one of our scientists who would have been 100 this week, 100 years old, if she was still alive. And her name is Marie Tharp, and this is a book about her life. It's called Ocean Speaks, How Marie Tharp Revealed the Ocean's Biggest Secret. People ask me, why are we still talking about Marie Tharp all these years later? And what is so fascinating about her story? Well, I think the fact that she made one of the most famous maps of all time is a huge part of that. I mean, her scientific contributions to the understanding of the Earth were profoundly important. But I think we still think about her too because her story is so interesting. From the time she was a small child, she had a passion for exploring the Earth, and she followed that passion, even though barriers were continually thrown in her path. So that spirit of exploration and courage and perseverance, I think, is what makes her story so powerful and so inspiring. Marie showed the map to her colleague. He yelled, he argued, "It must be a mistake. Nothing but foolish, silly girl talk." He told Marie to redo her work. She knew her map was correct and was eager to prove it. Marie's story has always been an inspiration to me. I've encountered challenges in my career, times when I proposed ideas that weren't well received and in fact dismissed often. And you have to use people like Marie as your inspiration to persevere and to stick to your guns, which she clearly did, and stay true to your beliefs and yourself. One of the things that's a little bit sad about Marie's story that was very typical from this time and place 50 years ago is that even though some people recognized how important her work was, collectively it wasn't really given the celebration and respect that it deserved when she was alive. And really it's only been in the last 20 years that people have truly come to appreciate how much of what we know came directly from Marie and not all the men around her. This is a print from the very earliest generations of maps that Marie wrote. You can see it's very much just ink and pen, beautiful. But the map, the Marie Tharp map that most people are familiar with is this one over here. And about 10 years later, National Geographic published this map. Came from Marie Tharp. It says he's in Tharp up there because they couldn't put a woman first. But this is the map that most people would be familiar with because it was sent to everybody who had a subscription to National Geographic. We take hope in thinking about the fact that I don't believe that would have happened today. There's so many more women in science. The contributions of women are acknowledged and indeed celebrated at times. She was an early pioneer, ever forward.